Marketing and Skills Council. So we feel really proud to inform that after the grand success of Creative Warrior programs in universities, colleges, academic institutions and schools, Creative Warrior is now going digital and launching free online courses from tomorrow. Yes, tomorrow, May 13th at 11:30 a.m. You can be ready with your dancing shoes because we have free dance classes by DanceSmith. DanceSmith is the company that has its name registered for its proficiency in many record books. Limca Book of Records, Asia Book of Records, and has been honored with World Kings Awards by World Records Union. So get ready and do register on vidyadan.net to book your seats for tomorrow's session. So today we have Dr. Anuj Kacker with us. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Pooja. It's my pleasure to be here.
Thank you, sir. Dr. Kacker is a graduate from IIT and IIM with 34 years of experience, out of which the last 17 years have been in the education and training with Aptech Limited. Currently, Dr. Kacker is a president and executive director with Aptech Limited, a leader in career education and training. The two leading brands of M&E education, that is Arena Animation and Mac, are part of Aptech. Sir, I really wish to thank you for accepting our request and be with us to share your knowledge and wisdom.
It's my pleasure to be here. Thank you.
So with your permission, if you allow, we can have all our students, our attendees, click a selfie with you and post on the social media by tagging Vidyadan and MESC. And they can win exciting prizes also.
Most certainly, yes. Most certainly.
Okay. So, going ahead, I'd like to know how do you think about current situation? How do you think media and entertainment industry has been impacted by COVID-19?
Obviously, COVID is an event which happens maybe once in a lifetime, and it is not something which we can take lightly or we should take lightly. It is an event which will impact not only our lives, but probably will be talked about for years to come and generations to come. There will be movies made on this times. There will be books written on these times. And the fact that we are today going through these times is itself in a way a seminal event or a historic event. But Pooja, before I proceed, I need a input from you. What would be the preferred language of the audience? Should I speak in English? Should I speak in Hindi? Should I speak in both?
Both would be good.
Both would be good. So I will try. What I will do is I will speak first in English, and the synopsis of this I will give you in Hindi as well, just sure, for the benefit of both the types of audiences who may be there. So these are the events. This event is something which we will remember for entire life. The students who are today young, when they will become my age, they will still talk about it. So the important point for the students and the younger generation, or in fact, all of us to remember today, is that it is when we look back, maybe 10 years from now, 15 years from now, 50 years from now, it is not what happened in this time that will be remembered. What you will remember is what you did at this time. How did you react? How did you live your life at this point of time? And if you feel at that time, oh, I could have done this, but I did not do, or I could have done that, but I did not do it, you will feel bad about it. So it is important not to be overwhelmed or not to be scared or not to be disheartened by what are the events around us, but really to take it in a very positive manner and do your best to be able to live the opportunities which it is also presenting itself.
Yeah.
Now, coming specifically to media and entertainment, see, media and entertainment has many, 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 many different components, at least 9 different components. Of course, the most commonly talked about is the films that we go to the halls to see are Shah Rukh Khan's and the Aamir Khan's and the Amitabh Bachchan's of this world entertain us. So that's a very big component. then you have advertising as a very big component of media and entertainment. You have the newspapers and the publications that come out every day as part of the media and entertainment. And of course, you have other important components like animation, like visual effects, like gaming, like digital media, and which is the focus of today's discussion, which I'm going to talk about. Now, all these different components will be impacted differently. It is not right to put all the that all of them will be impacted in the same way. There will be segments of this industry which will be impacted negatively. There will be segments of this industry which will really, it's a great opportunity for those industries to grow, and they will grow as a result of what is happening today. So it's a mixed bag. The other point to remember is that there are three components, or the four components, when you look at any one particular segment. Firstly is the content. So what is the content being made? Is it going to be made more, or is it going to be made less? Second is the consumption. Are more people going to watch that content or consume that content, or less people are going to consume that content? The third is what I call monetization, or money making. Are the companies who are in the institutes and everybody else who are doing this, are they going to make money doing this, or are they going to lose money doing this? And fourth, and which I think is the most important part for in the light of the audience today, is what kind of careers are possible and whether those will be impacted positively or negatively. So what I hope to do in my talk today is to be able to dissect this a little bit further, to be able to give you a synopsis of what it will mean for each one of these components of this industry, particularly when you're looking at it from the fourth aspect. The first three aspects, while being important, are not directly impacting the audience who are listening to us today. So we are going to focus on the those aspects which are going to impact the audience who are going to look at listening to us today, mainly the students and those who are wanting to get into this field, and see which components and what of these parts, which parts of this industry will actually benefit these students and what they should be doing.
Okay. So that really answers my question, because current situation is really different from our regular situations. So during the COVID situation, we have many students who did not get a chance to appear for their examination of class 12. What is your suggestion for those students, and how do you think they can sense their creative side and utilize the same at this time?
See, I think for those students who have just passing out of 10 plus 2, or even just completing the 10th. I mean, it is important for them, for their own future, to be able to treat this as a non-event. They have to, what they have to do, what they would have been otherwise being doing at, in the month of May and June, which is really chalking out what is the career path ahead for them. I think irrespective of when those examinations will happen, let that not weigh on your mind. What should weigh on your mind is, what should I want to do with my life, which is the career I want to choose, and what are the pluses and minuses of doing that? See, you have to understand one thing. No matter how big the COVID situation is, it is still going to go away sooner, hopefully, than later. But what the decisions that you take today are going to impact your entire life. So do not put your entire life on hold for any reason. It is critically important, particularly for those who are passing out of the class 12, to be able to take the career decisions very quickly and with the right amount of information.
Yeah, right. So we need to make right choice at the right time. And this is the right time. So as we can see, the overall education industry seems to be taking on using digital platforms for training. So how do you see the acceptability of online or a blended mode of training, and how impactful it is?
Firstly, I must tell you that online education or online training is not something which is new or which was born with because of the COVID. It has existed for the last 10 years. And in different formats, people have been using or not using online platforms for education and training in a variety of ways. Yes, we are today in a lockdown situation, and therefore that becomes the only option, so to speak. And therefore people are, looking at this very openly and in greater numbers, which is fine, which is what should be done. And our students should also take advantage of whatever online educations are today being provided to them. But the issue of online or non-online education or blended education or physical education is much broader, and it should be treated outside the prism of the COVID scenario which exists today. When you look at, when you're training yourself for your life or a job, your first criteria should be, what am I going to want to be employed in? And therefore, what are the skills that I need to be able to employed, to be employed in those skills? Let's take the first, the case of people who are seeking their first jobs, you know, who passed out of class 12 and they're trying to make a career, or they're doing the graduation or just finished their graduation, and they are trying to figure out what line to take or what stream to catch so that their life is secured. For those people, I think the important thing to realize is that no matter what you learn today, especially in the field of technology or technological-led education or in those kind of areas, no matter what you learn, which is the latest today, is going to be obsolete in 5 years' time. Okay, so whether it, or maybe sooner than that, you can learn Maya, you can learn 3D Max, you can learn Photoshop, you can learn so many different kinds of skills. But most of the skills which have a technological backbone are going to be obsolete, as technology advances. So what is it that you are trying to learn? Why are you trying to learn anything? It's not that you're trying to learn just those technologies. What you're trying to learn is how to learn. That is far more important than learning those specific skills or specific subject matters. While that is important in its own way, but you know, you have to look at, you have to improve your creativity. You have to improve your curiosity. You have to learn teamwork. You have to learn resilience. Resilience is a big word, but really what it boils down to is, okay, when something hits you bad, how do you quickly rebound from that and come back and fly again? So those are the skills, your communication skills. So those are the kind of skills which are equally important when you're looking for a job, as well as the technical skills that you would learn. Therefore, when you're looking at whether online or non-online education, you have to look at these aspects as to whether this method of education is going to be able to give you, give me these kind of skills as well, in addition to my normal skills. It is not that it is not possible to do it in an online world. It is possible, but it is difficult. And therefore, it requires a great amount of, given the cost and time and practice, to be able to, for the students to impart these skills. Now, these skills will outlast them for a greater portion of their life. It is not going to be obsolete in 3 years, 5 years' time. These will be, which will, they will carry with them through their entire professional career. And that is what they should be focusing on. Yeah, I promised that I will quickly translate this in Hindi, so I will just do that in a second. I'll just put all your three questions together. Pehla question tha ki media and entertainment kshetr mein COVID ka kya impact hoga. To pehla mera ye kehna hai ki media entertainment ek kshetr nahi hai. Iske kahi bhag hain. Aur har bhag pe alag alag farak padega, alag alag impact aayega. To aapko ye dekhna hai ki kis bhag pe kis क्षेत्र में ज्यादा है, किसमें कम है, किसमें पॉजिटिव है. बहुत सारे क्षेत्र हैं इसमें जिसमें बहुत पॉजिटिव इफेक्ट होने वाला है, पर्टिकुलरली थिंग्स लाइक डिजिटल मीडिया एंड गेमिंग एंड स्टफ लाइक दैट. तो आपने भी ये चीज बड़े ध्यान से सोचनी है कि आपने क्या करना है और कौन से क्षेत्र चूज करने हैं जिसका इम्पैक्ट पॉजिटिव हो. दूसरी बात, इस माहौल में क्या होता है, बहुत सारी नेगेटिव इन्फ्लुएंसेस आते हैं और नई नेगेटिव न्यूज आती रहती है, ये हो गया, वो हो गया, रोज नए नए खबर आ रहे हैं, नए नए लोग आ रहे हैं, तरह तरह की बातें हो रही हैं, बट आपने ये अंदाजा लगाना है कि आप जो आज डिसीजन ले रहे हैं वो अगले 3 महीने का या 3 साल का डिसीजन नहीं है, आप बड़े लंबे अरसे के लिए ये डिसीजन ले रहे हैं। तो एक सिर्फ कोविड के चलते हुए अगर आप एक डिसीजन लेते हैं तो शायद आपकी लाइफ भर के लिए गलत डिसीजन हो सकता है, आपने उसके ऊपर उठ के देखना है, पर्टिकुलरली जब आप करियर की बात करते हैं। हाँ, जो लोग फिल्म बनाते हैं या प्रोड्यूस करते हैं या जो कंपनी चलाती है उनके लिए क्राइटेरिया अलग हो सकते हैं, बट आपने अपने नजरिए से देखना है कि अगर आपके नजरिए से जब तक आप पास आउट करोगे क्या सिचुएशन होने वाला है और उसके तहत आपने ये डिसीजन लेना है। दूसरा क्वेश्चन था रिगार्डिंग दी ऑनलाइन वर्सेस ऑफलाइन डिलीवरी। हाँ, बहुत तरीके की बातें हो रही हैं एंड ऑनलाइन डिलीवरी बहुत आजकल क्योंकि लॉकडाउन सब जगह है और अधिकांश देश में आज लॉकडाउन की स्थिति है तो स्टूडेंट्स के पास बहुत ज़्यादा चॉइसेस नहीं है कि वो क्या कर पाए इस स्थिति में, तो वो लोग ऑनलाइन एजुकेशन कर रहे हैं और अच्छी बात है और करना चाहिए। एंड बट आपने ये देखना चाहिए कि मेरे को अगर कोई भी तकनीकी क्षेत्र में जाना है, टेक्नोलॉजिकल एजुकेशन करनी है, तो उसका उससे मेरा अगर मेरा ऑब्जेक्टिव ये है कि मेरे को जॉब मिलना चाहिए या मेरी स्किल्स बढ़नी चाहिए, वो ज्यादातर लोगों का वो एक ऑब्जेक्टिव रहता है, खासकर जिनका पहला जॉब है, और उनके लिए ये देखना है कि उनको लाइफ लॉन्ग स्किल्स मिल पा रही हैं कि सिर्फ एक हम एक टेक्नोलॉजी या एक स्किल सीख रहे हैं जो हो सकता है 3 साल बाद खुद ही ऑब्सोलीट हो जाएगी क्योंकि तकनीक द टेक्नोलॉजी विल इम्प्रूव फर्दर। तो उनको उस नजरिए से देख के अपनी अपनी चॉइस करनी चाहिए कि जो सॉफ्ट स्किल्स हैं, आपके जो रेजिलियंस के स्किल्स हैं, क्रिएटिविटी है, क्यूरियोसिटी है, क्या आपको वो मिल पा रही है उस जरिए, यदि हाँ तो वो करना चाहिए, नहीं तो आपने कोई और रास्ता चूज करना चाहिए।
जी बिल्कुल सर। सो सर एक रिक्वेस्ट करूंगी मैं, आप हमारी सारी ऑडियंस को कुछ प्रेजेंटेशन के थ्रू कुछ ज्यादा डिटेल्स दे सकते हैं, लाइक वी ऑल विल बी डिलाइटेड इफ एनी प्रेजेंटेशन वेयर यू सी एनिमेशन वीएफएक्स गेमिंग इंडस्ट्री एंड अपॉर्चुनिटीज एंड चैलेंजेस फॉर द इंडस्ट्री कि आगे।
या सर्टेनली आई वुड लाइक टू डू दैट एंड सो आई विल गिव मी अ मिनट व्हाइल आई विल ओपन दिस प्रेजेंटेशन।
श्योर सर।
आप लोग देख सकते हैं पूजा, मेरा स्क्रीन दिखाई दे रहा है?
हाँ जी सर बिल्कुल।
ओके, सो जैसे मैंने कहा कि आई एम गोइंग टू बी टॉकिंग अबाउट करियर अपॉर्चुनिटीज इन मीडिया एंड एंटरटेनमेंट एंड विद इन मीडिया एंड एंटरटेनमेंट आई एम गोइंग टू फोकस मोर ऑन एनिमेशन वीएफएक्स एंड द गेमिंग इंडस्ट्री मेनली बिकॉज दैट इज द एरिया विच आई हैव मैक्सिमम फेमिलियरिटी विद एंड मैं कोशिश करूंगा कि हिंदी और इंग्लिश दोनों में बोलने की, लेकिन टाइम को मद्देनजर रखते हुए पहले मैं इंग्लिश में बोलूंगा, उसका सिनॉप्सिस मैं हिंदी में देने की कोशिश करूंगा, शायद स्लाइड बाय स्लाइड ना कर पाऊँ यह बिकॉज नहीं तो डबल टाइम लगेगा, लेकिन कोशिश करूंगा कि जो इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट्स हैं उसको मैं हिंदी में भी कवर करूँ। आई विल ट्राई टू स्पीक इन बोथ द लैंग्वेजेस हिंदी एंड इंग्लिश एंड कवर द मेन पॉइंट्स इन बोथ द लैंग्वेजेस। I just said disclaimer, I've used many images in this presentation and these images are copyrighted by different companies and different owners and those copyrights are acknowledged. Agar hum media and entertainment, MNE hai, media and entertainment. If we talk about the media and entertainment sectors, it is a huge industry. I mean, it is 182,000 crores. It's huge. Or why it is so huge? Because it comprises of all these parts that I talked about. The biggest, of course, is films, which is there. Another very big is TV, jo hum all, itne sare channels hain, itne sare shows हैं जो हम टीवी पे रोज देखते हैं वो इस इंडस्ट्री का भाग है. Then print, all the various newspapers, advertisings, which is there, is also part of this industry. Iske ilawa hai animation and visual effects, which is again very, very big segment of this industry. Yes. There is gaming, which is coming up in a big way. There is digital media, and I will talk more about digital media also. Then there is radio, there is music, and there is what we call as out of home, OOH, jo outdoor advertising wagera hoti hai. So all these are part of the media and entertainment industry. What we will focus on is today, for today's discussion, is animation and visual effects, gaming, digital media, although we will touch upon the others also, but this will be the main focus of our discussion today. Pehle hum dekhte hain ki abhi tak kya growth raha hai is industry ka last year, COVID ke pehle. मैं कोविड के बाद की भी बात करूंगा बाद में, बट लेट अस फर्स्ट पुट आवर माइंड्स टू व्हाट इज द सिनेरियो प्रायर टू कोविड एंड व्हिच वर द एरियाज व्हिच वर ग्रोइंग. सो इफ यू सी द टॉप थ्री अमंग दीज ऑल दीज सेक्टर्स एंड दीज आर द फ्रॉम द फिकी ईएनवाई रिपोर्ट व्हिच इज द मोस्ट रिलायबल रिपोर्ट इन दिस इंडस्ट्री. द टॉप थ्री हैव बीन ऑनलाइन गेमिंग, डिजिटल मीडिया एंड एनिमेशन एंड विजुअल इफेक्ट्स. इसीलिए मैंने चूज किया है कि पहले आज हम इन तीन की बात ज्यादा करेंगे. इसके अलावा और भी सेक्टर्स हैं जिनका ग्रोथ कम रहा है और कुछ का नेगेटिव भी रहा है कोविड के पहले भी, बट ओवरऑल करीब 9% का ग्रोथ रहा है मीडिया एंड एंटरटेनमेंट में. बट आप देख सकते हैं कि इस स्लाइड में कि गेमिंग, डिजिटल मीडिया और एनिमेशन का इससे कहीं अधिक रहा है. तो पहले एनिमेशन और विजुअल इफेक्ट्स की बात करते हैं. लेट अस टॉक अबाउट एनिमेशन एंड विजुअल इफेक्ट्स फर्स्ट. Although many of you may be familiar with what is animation, we have all watched animation films, but for the benefit of those people who are maybe wondering what really is animation about, animation is just a capturing of sequential images. Aur jab us images ko ek ke baad jaldi 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 dekhte hain to use ek animated ek simulation hota hai motion ka bhi. Get the impression of motion, although each one of those pictures are still. For those of you, we used to have these kind of books which you see on the screen, and if you flip through those books quickly, you get a image which appears to move. Any animation that you see today is nothing but a sequence of still images which are being projected one after the other in rapid succession, so it gives you an illusion of motion. एनिमेशन एक स्टैटिक इमेजेस को जल्दी जल्दी प्ले करके उसको एक मोशन का रूप या मोशन का एक फीलिंग आती है कि ये चीज मूव कर रहा है. दैट इज रियली एनिमेशन. देयर आर वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ एनिमेशन. व्हाई एम आई टेकिंग यू थ्रू दिस? यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. अनलेस यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट रियली दीज फैसेट्स मीन, यू मे नॉट बी एबल टू फुली ग्रास्प which career choice is right for you. Then there is something called 2D classical animation. Tom and Jerry, jo hum logon ne aapne bhi dekha, humne bhi dekha, sabne dekha hai. Tom and Jerry is a classical 2D animation kind of studio. Then today you have 2D digital animation, which is the digitized version of classical animation. It is also 2D, where every screen is 2D. Chota beam aapne dekha hoga, aur bhi dekhe honge. Then right, then you have 3D animation. 3D animation, jaise ye minions ka aapko screen pe dikh raha hai, which gives a overall feel. Abhi aap log jo movies dekhte hain screen cinema halls mein jaake animation movies, wo zyadatar aap 3D animation movies dekhte hain. Iske ilawa stop motion animation hota hai, which is like again, play static images, but you use objects to create that image. So you create images of those objects. Agar aapne Tare Zameen Pe dekhi hai, so if you have seen the movie Tare Zameen Pe, and if you remember the title sequence of that, where those fishes are going and those objects are moving, that is stop motion animation. So within animation also, there are different types of animations which are there. दूसरा मैंने नाम लिया, आई हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट विजुअल इफेक्ट्स. Now, people get confused. What is animation? What is visual effects? Now, visual effects is nothing, but it is a computer-generated imagery. Why is this image? So things which are done on the computer to make them look real, where there is nothing actually happening which is real, but it is all done on the computer, whereas the audience, when they are looking at those images, for them, it appears that it is real. So why is visual effects resorted to? Why don't people just go and shoot real people? Why do they create things? They do it because either it is not safe. I mean, if you have to show somebody jumping the building or a car catching fire, it is not safe to do that. Or it may be too costly to do that.
Right.
Or it may be just not practical to do that. To do a variety of effects, visual effects are resorted, and they're used in every movie, in every advertising that you see, in every kind of content that you see. So, you have seen Mowgli, the movie. So you have seen, it is nothing, everything except the little boy. There was nothing which was not done on the computer. The whole movie was except the little boy, and everything else, including the bug, the leopard, the panther, is on the computer. And when you're watching it, you can't really make out at all. So everything is done on the computer to be able to generate that. And the people who do that are either visual effect artists or animators. And within this, there are multiple roles and multiple types of people which are required to create this kind of content. Of course, this is a huge industry by itself, as I mentioned to you. By last year, it was growing almost at 20%, at around 9,400 crores today. I mean, I'm not trying to impress you by figures, but you just imagine the amount of work which is being done in this area of animation and visual effects. And I'm going to talk to a little bit more about this. VFX also is one of the fastest growing industries. It is growing by 25%. And one of the questions which will be there in everybody's mind, yes, these were figures last year. What is going to be the impact of COVID on this? And I am going to talk about this at the end of the presentation. So aap log thoda wait kariye uske liye. But first, important is to understand what really is animation, visual effects, so that when you are making a choice, whether it is the right field for you or not, it is important to understand two or three things. Is this the kind of thing which I would like to do? Number two, is this an industry which is big enough? Third, is it a growing industry? Ye teen cheezein aapne apne dimag mein rakhni hai. Growth aaj ka nahi, growth 5 saal ka kya hone wala hai, 10 saal ka kya hone wala hai, 25 saal ka kya hone wala hai. Ye aapne apne aap ko questions poochne hai when you are trying to take a career choice. So there are now who produces these films or these images? I'm not talking about films. I'm using films, but it is meant much more than films itself. They are made by specialized people or companies, which could be studios, which are either international studios or Indian studios. They are small studios, medium-sized studios, very big studios, international studios who do this work. There are some studios who do the full work from end to end of producing a film or an advertisement or any particular content. There are some people who do only one or two scenes or one particular aspect of the particular scene, and that's the total work they do. And then they send it back to the filmmakers and they put it into the rest of the film. Now, if you know this, there are several films, The Lion King, you would have seen, Avengers Endgame, the Marvel movie which came out. These are all movies for which work was done in India. And today there are 300 animation studios and more than 50 international VFX studios in India. They are small, big, medium-sized, and employing as many as some from 10 people to 5,000 people. It depends on the size of the studio. So it's a huge array. Everybody is doing different types of work. Everybody is doing different aspects of the work of animation, visual effects. But the fact to remember is there are many, 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 many of them located in all parts of India who are doing this. Let's see what kind of work. I said different types of work is done in the animation industry. Right now, first I'm going to talk about animation, then I'm going to talk about visual effects. First, animation. Pehle main animation ki baat karunga, phir main visual effects ki baat karunga. So, animation mein films hum log jante hain. Humne sab movies dekhi hain. Chota Bheem hai. We have seen Avengers. We have seen Lion King, Life of Pi. We have seen Mowgli. We have seen hundreds of animation films. Now, as I said, these films are made of either partly or fully in various animation studios. And those people are where who employ people who have studied in these fields. So firstly, they do make films. Then there are services. Services is more like end-to-end. Okay? Suppose there is a producer who wants to say, produce an ad, an animated ad. So he goes to a studio and he says, listen, I want to create an animated ad and this is my storyline. Can you do the ad for me? The studio does the full work, produces the ad, animated, and gives it back to the producer. That's a full service thing. Or it could be IP production, IP intellectual property, which if a Superman movie has to be made or Batman movie has to be made. Now these are IPs owned by international studios who say, now I am going to give you only a little bit of this work. You produce this scene where Superman is jumping from building X to building Y. Idhar se udhar jump karna hai, ye scene aap mere ko produce karke dijiye in an animated fashion. Or something else like that. So various kinds of work which is there. Advertisements are produced. There is a lot of work happening in the animation industry for the digital media. And I will talk about and show you some examples of this later. There's a lot of work which is happening in different areas of the animation industry. So these are some of the examples of animation films that were made in 2019 alone, which were released, the big shots. And this is a small of them. There are hundreds more. DreamWorks, Disney, Pixar, Blue Sky, Illumination, Pets 2. They made Toy Story 4. And I would strongly encourage those of you who are wanting to be part of this industry to see movies. It's a very important, animated movies. The more you see, the more you will learn. So you must watch these movies which are produced, and you will start appreciating the art behind the movie, art behind the entertainment. There's some more animation movies which were released last year. Frenemies was there. Klaus was to be released. Pikachu, you may have heard. Spices in Disguise. Lion King, one of the very big ones. And this was made in Bangalore by a very big studio called MPC, which has offices. It's an international studio. We have offices in Bangalore, London, LA, in US. And they delivered nearly 1,500 shots, means 1,500 scenes of the movie were made by MPC. Others could have been made by others. All this is brought together into one movie by Disney. What about India? In India also, there are many, many movies which are happening, not only for the cinemas, but also for digital and for TV. Many of you would have seen Little Bheem, Mighty Little Bheem, which was made by Green Gold Animation, an Indian studio, in collaboration with Netflix. Now, this was the first one where it was made in, which was made exclusively for Netflix. So today there is animation work which is done exclusively for the digital world itself. So it need not be released in cinemas at all. Then you had Little Singham, which was a Rohit Shetty production, and Reliance, and done by Reliance Animation. which is Karam Chakra, which was the first Indian anime. Anime is a Japanese form of animation. It was done in India for the first time by Studio Durga, and Gitanjali Rao, who's one of the very, very well-known animation professionals in India, made Bombay Rose. I've taken only three or four just to give you a sampling. There are hundreds and hundreds more than these. Let's look at some more. There was 100 Wolf Redefined. These are all the recent ones which I've talked about. There's Latte and the Magic Waterstone by Film CGI Studio. Cosmos by Maya made Inspector Chingum. And Mondo Yan by Toons Animation in Down South. There are a lot of animation which was done for TV advertising, Goo Goos and 7-Up advertisements, and the Lamput advertisements which were made by Vaibhav Kumaresh, again a very well-known Indian animator, with some of the ones which were released recently. So as you can see, there are a lot of work happening across international, across India, and across the whole spectrum. Similarly, the VFX is also used for films. There is VFX being done for television. There is VFX being done for advertisements. There is VFX being done for digital media. So it is not only that, you should not imagine that VFX is done only for very big budget movies. No, there are different types of VFX, which is done for various types of content all across. So there is digital media, visual effects in Bollywood is done in digital. Regional movies are using visual effects in a big way. Television is using visual effects in a big way. 1917 is a big movie which was to be released, which was where a lot of VFX has been done. DNEG is one of the prominent studios in India which does a lot of visual effects work. So in India, the visual effects work which is done is of the highest level. In fact, 77% of the visual effects work which is done in India is done for international studios. Mm-hmm. So the work which is done in Indian studios, gone are the days when it was basic or it was done very elementary kind of work. Today, the Indian studios or studios based in India are doing the best quality work for the best movies which are released and winning Oscars everywhere. These are some of the Hollywood VFX work which is there, done by studios like DNEG, MPC, Framestore, Legend 3D, Method Studio and Digital Domain, which are some of the very prominent studios who are doing VFX work for the Hollywood industry in India. Again, some MIB, Men in Black, Avengers Endgame, which was released last year by Marvel, all work which is done in India. So very often, if you stay to the end, and my request to those people who get into this industry, please do not walk out of the cinema halls or shut off your TV before the credits are finished. Because credits is where your name is going to appear. So please have the respect to listen, to read the names of the studios and those people who have worked on it. And you will be surprised how many Indian names you will see there in the best of Hollywood movies. Because a lot of work is happening for that in India. So next time when you watch an animation movie or one which has a lot of visual effects, look for those Indian names and you will see a lot of them done by Indians who have been working there. And of course, a lot of them are from institutes like ARENA and MAC, which are part of Aptic. Bollywood movies, which use a lot of, Tanaji used a lot of visual effects, War, Mission Mangal, and domestic visual effects industry is today growing, one of the fastest growing industries. It's growing 30% every year. And some of the prominent studios, NYVFX Wala, which is Ajay Devgan's venture, Yash Raj Films, Red Chilies, which is Shah Rukh Khan's venture, Famulous, Makuta Arts. Makuta is run by a very famous person called Pete Draper, based in Hyderabad, who is a very prominent VFX artists in India, Redefine, which is the new avatar of Prime Focus, which is a lot of VFX studios are there in India who are doing excellent work today. Some of the movies were Bollywood movies, which had a lot of visual effects, Baghi 3, Bharat, Panipat, Uri, some of them are to be released in the coming days. See, these are some of the movies which will get released as and when the we come out of the lockdown situations. This is a movie called 83. This is on the Indian cricket team, which won the 83 World Cup. The cricket works very well in India. Maidan is also about a football coach from Bengal who coached the Indian team, and many others. Regional films. A lot of VFX is used in regional films. And normally when particularly South India and Bengal, when they use this, make these regional films, they also release it in multiple language. So you have Mamangam, you have Lucifer, you have Trance, and many other South Indian films, which are made in Telugu and then released in Tamil, Malayalam, Kannada, and they make it in one of them and then dub it in others and to have a wider release. Movies like Pehlwan, Panchatantra, Shivaji Suratkal, so many of them which have been made in the recent past. What about VFX, as I told you yesterday, made for digital also. Today, higher and higher budgets are being made for people. When I say digital, this is for OTT platforms like Netflix, Hotstar, Sony Live, Voot, so many other platforms today, which you are today familiar with, get content made exclusively for them. Yani ye jo film ban rahi hain, ye jaise Netflix ho gaya, Hotstar ho gaya, Voot hai, Sony Live hai, aise bahut sare OTT platforms hain jiske liye kaam ho raha hai. Aapne jaise piche akhbaron mein padha hoga ki Reliance Jio ka bahut powerful program hai to have Wi-Fi connectivity in the remotest corner of the world, and Facebook has also invested in the company. So there is a lot of work which is happening today for the digital world itself. Sacred Games, aap log ne shayad dekha hoga, bahut popular work tha, which had a lot of visual effects used in the footage. TV series. Bahut sare TV series hai, Radha Krishna, Ganesh, mythological, non-mythological movies India mein bahut banti hain, VFX TV series bante hain, aur isme bahut VFX utilize hota hai. Main aapko ek pura ek picture paint karna chah raha hoon ki jab aap animation ya visual effects ko dekhte hain, wo sirf ek nazariye se nahi dekhiye ki jo aap sirf movie mein jaake dekhte hain ya cinema hall mein dekhte hain. Ye bahut bada canvas hai, iske bahut sare aur areas hain jahan pe visual effects ya animation use hota hai, aur ye aap log ko jana zaruri hai. TV advertisements, another big areas. I don't know if some of my favorites, which I have just taken up my favorite advertisements and put in there. Dr. Fixit, which had Amitabh Bachchan there. We had Dixie Scott with Salman Khan in the TV ads. So there are a lot of TV ads which also use VFX. So VFX is critical for the film segment growth or the digital segment growth or for growth in advertising, growth in any aspect of visual content. So ye abhi tak jo baat kari thi, we had talked about we had talked about animation and visual effects. We have covered two parts. We have covered animation and visual effects. We are coming to the third one, which is digital media. I will move faster a bit. So digital media, what is digital media? Digital media is really, which is where, you know, whether it's your phones, whether it's your TV, which is content, which is consumed directly on various screens, personal screens. आपका टीवी हो सकता है, आपका मोबाइल हो सकता है, जिसपे आप कंटेंट या कोई भी विजुअल कंटेंट कंज्यूम करते हैं या देखते हैं. तो इसमें क्योंकि डिजिटल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर बढ़ रहा है, जैसे मैंने रिलायंस जियो का नाम लिया है, बट और भी है जो कोने कोने में फैल रहा है, तो इससे बहुत ज़्यादा ग्रोथ आ रही है इन द कंजम्पशन ऑफ डिजिटल कंटेंट इन द इवन इन द स्मॉल टाउन्स इन इंडिया. एंड आई मेंशन हाउ फेसबुक एंड अदर कंपनीज हैव इन्वेस्टेड इनटू दिस वेंचर आल्सो टू गिव इट फर्दर ग्रोथ. सो देयर विल लॉट ऑफ पोटेंशियल एंड दिस इज वन एरिया विच इज not impacted by lockdown or COVID at all. In fact, it has grown much more because of the COVID and the lockdown effects. So there is same kind of work which you're doing in animation, visual effects, and everything is used in digital media also. As more and more TVs are there, people, kaiyon ke paas pehle ek TV hote the, aajkal do TV hote hain, pehle ek mobile hota tha, aaj sabke paas apne apne mobile ho gaye hain. तो इससे वजह से कंजम्पशन बहुत बढ़ रहा है. जो ओटीटी प्लेटफॉर्म्स है, ओटीटी ओवर द टॉप प्लेटफॉर्म्स कहते हैं इनको, जैसे हॉटस्टार हो गया, नेटफ्लिक्स हो गया, ऐसे जो बाकी अमेज़न प्राइम है, ऐसे जितने प्लेटफॉर्म्स हैं, कि इनका ग्रोथ मालूम है आपको कितना, ओवर 100% इन दिस पीरियड. सो इट्स अ फिनोमिनल ग्रोथ दैट दिस एरिया इज विटनेसिंग एंड यू शुड सर्टनली कंसिडर बींग पार्ट ऑफ दिस इंडस्ट्री. Digital advertising is one of the area which is again growing very, very fast. There is more demand for digital content, things like Facebook Live, Instagram TV, Snapchat, TikTok. All this require content. जब मैं content बोलता हूँ, मेरे का एक story है, एक visual effect है, एक snippet है, एक 10 second का ad है, एक 3 minute की film है, ऐसे बहुत सारा content है जो YouTube के लिए, Facebook के लिए, Instagram के लिए, Snapchat के लिए, TikTok के लिए बनाया जा रहा है आज की तारीख में. एंड यू कैन बी पार्ट ऑफ दिस वंडरफुल वर्ल्ड ऑल्सो विद द रिक्वायर्ड स्किल्स. Netflix ड्यूरिंग दिस कोविड पीरियड और लॉकडाउन पीरियड, नॉट सरप्राइजिंगली, वॉज द फास्टेस्ट ग्रोइंग प्लेटफॉर्म ever seen. They have not witnessed such a big growth ever. YouTube grew by 21% in the lockdown, in the COVID period. They were garnered more than 30,000 crore views. 30,000 crore. 3 lakh crore impressions. 90% of the video views came through mobile phones. क्योंकि हम लोग सब लोग आज की तारीख में मोबाइल में स्क्रीन पे देखते रहते हैं, YouTube है, Netflix है, और भी जितने प्रोग्राम्स हैं, तो the consumption of video has increased many fold because of the COVID period. जैसे मैंने पहले कहा, कुछ एरियाज हैं जिसकी वजह से बहुत पॉजिटिव इम्पैक्ट भी आया है. This is one of them. There is increasing trend of video calling. जैसे हम लोग बात कर रहे हैं आज Zoom पे, YouTube पे कुछ लोग देख रहे हैं, WhatsApp पे हम लोग video call करते हैं, Skype, Facebook Messenger. All this require technologies and content which is relevant and to be able to be developed through skills which are taught to you through the digital media courses. So digital media is going to be one of the fastest growing segments. कोविड और नो कोविड, इनफैक्ट कोविड की वजह से इसकी ग्रोथ और बढ़ गई है. इट वुड एज यू इफ यू हैव सीन, इफ यू रिमेंबर माय फर्स्ट स्लाइड, दिस वाज टॉप इवन बिफोर द कोविड. इट इज बिकमिंग सुपर फास्ट आफ्टर द कोविड. सो इट इज एरियाज व्हिच यू शुड सीरियसली लुक एट. सो वी हैव कवर्ड एनिमेशन, वी हैव कवर्ड विजुअल इफेक्ट्स, वी हैव कवर्ड डिजिटल मीडिया. नाउ आई कम टू द फोर्थ, विच इज gaming and interactive design. Now in the area of gaming and interactive design is another area which has seen much, much faster growth after COVID than what it was before COVID. It was anyway one of the top three in the before COVID. After COVID, it is growing even faster. So let's understand a little bit more about this area. What is required? What are the career opportunities or what is required in this gaming and interactive design? Again, online grooming in last year growing at 40%, and because of COVID, it is expected to grow even much faster than 40%. Do you know how many gamers there are in India today? There are more than 30 crore gamers in India today, as we speak.
Huge.
30 crore log hain jo gamers hain. Unme se kuch aap log hain jo aaj dekh rahe hain. 250 aisi game development companies hain India mein. Jo aaj ki tarikh mein different types of games bana rahi hain and employing thousands and thousands of people in this area. And this is an area which is growth. Aaj ki tarikh mein jobs jyada hain, log kam hain is area mein. Globally also the market size and revenue of the gaming industry is increasing because many of these gaming companies in India do work for international gaming industry also. They make games and release it on App Store or Android platforms, iOS platforms, console gaming, different types of online gaming, different types of gaming ventures they release. Aur iske banane mein skill hai, development skills hai, art skills hai, design skills hai, jo aap seekh sakte hai and you can make a career in this industry also. Online gaming, YouTube gaming traffic was up 15% in March when lockdown was there. एक मैं सिर्फ एक गेम के बारे में आपको बताना चाहूंगा विच इज कॉल ऑफ ड्यूटी वॉर जोन. दिस वॉज रिलीज इन मार्च जब कोविड चालू हुआ इंडिया में और इसके 3 करोड़ प्लेयर्स हैं आज एक गेम के, वन गेम विच इज रिकॉर्ड एंड ओनली विच वॉज रिलीज ओनली इन मार्च. तो मार्च अप्रैल और भी आधा मई हुआ है. कैन यू इमेजिन द rate of growth which is there on one in game. Steam is another game which is user all-time concurrent user peak of 2 crore. 2 crore log is game ko khel rahe ek time pe, single time pe, concurrent user peak matlab ek time pe 2 crore log khel rahe the isko. So it's a huge industry, it requires huge potential and a huge growth. So let's talk about the online gaming. There are, I can read various examples. Aap log left hand side pe dekhte jaye screen pe kaun se games hain. Isme se kai games aap familiar hain. And the important thing to remember is that it is one of the fastest growing industries within the media and entertainment space. There were 500 crore game applications were downloaded in last year alone. The last point जरूर पढ़िएगा. Read the last point carefully. India is now in the top 5 markets. I will repeat this. India is now in the top 5 markets for the mobile gaming globally. Whether you take Japan, US, Europe, any country in Europe or Asia, Australia, all put together, we are among the top 5 markets for the mobile gaming globally. So obviously lot of games are being produced for the Indian market as per the Indian situations, and lot of Indian companies are capitalizing on this to cater to this market also. I have put down just some of the names which are there in some of the gaming studios in India. Rockstar Games, Lakshya Digital, the very prominent ones. Ubisoft, another very promising upcoming gaming studio in India. Yuzu Games, Suvo Digital. I'll not read all the names. You can see them on the screen. Now, each one of these people, they require hundreds of people for them to produce those games or produce aspects of the games that they are working on. These are only the some of them I have listed down here. There are more than 250 such gaming studios in India. So gaming has a very big future, and apart from animation, visual effects, digital media, you should also, may some of you would also like to consider careers in development of games or game art or game design. The fifth one I want to touch upon is multimedia and digital design. I will explain what this. So when you suppose it's a main prominent is graphic design. Now today so many websites are made, so many advertising is done, so many layouts are done, or so many font choices are done, logos are done, different areas of layouting, different areas of creative physical work which is done on the screen, work which is done either physically or on the screen, requires various multimedia specialists like graphic designers, multimedia designers, and so on and so forth. Where are the people who employs this? You know, people who do, let's say, web design get employed by web developers. People or companies which have into web developing, people who are into digital advertising. There is a lot of upcoming field in what is called UI and UX, user interface design and user experience, UI and UX, where there's a great shortage of people to be able to develop proper interfaces for the digital world. Every publication today also has a digital version of their publication, whether it's Times of India, whether it's Indian Express, whether it is any magazine today is also released digitally. Many of you would have seen that. All the studios also there in the digital world. So a lot of the work which is done physically, of course it is needed, but it's also needed digitally. So this area, which is interactive design and multimedia, is another area that you should consider very seriously if you want to be in the multimedia and the entertainment industry. And all these industries which I've talked about are the ones which are not impacted in any meaningful measure by COVID. These are the ones where in some of them which I highlighted are actually being helped by the COVID situation to grow faster. As social distancing and other things happen, it'll grow faster. Now, it is important, as I mentioned to you in the beginning, key, whatever you're learning today may become obsolete tomorrow. So you also have to look at what is the technologies of tomorrow, and are the courses that you are going to do preparing you for the technologies of tomorrow? That is very important for you to consider when deciding which course to do. First one is AR and VR, that is augmented reality and virtual reality. Hindi mein bol deta hu ki जो आप कोर्सेज करने चाह रहे हैं उसमें आपको ये भी जरूरी है देखना कि आप किसी भी तकनीकी क्षेत्र में जाएंगे तो वो उसमें एक ऑब्सोलेसेंस का चांस रहता है, उसको ऑब्सोलेट होने का चांस रहता है 3 साल में 5 साल में 7 साल में या 2 साल में. लेकिन आपको ये भी देखना है कि जो आप कोर्स चूज कर रहे हैं उसका आगे का क्या स्कोप है, या उस कोर्स में या उस कोर्स का पढ़ाने के ढंग में क्या राइट टेक्नोलॉजीज यूज हो रही हैं या नहीं यूज हो रही हैं, ये जरूरी देखना चाहिए आपको. पर्टिकुलरली एरियाज लाइक एआर एंड वीआर, ऑगमेंटेड रियलिटी एंड वर्चुअल रियलिटी. अब जैसे मैं अपने कर्सर से आपको दिखाना चाह रहा हूँ, जैसे ये नीचे आपको ये एलिफेंट डायनासोर टाइप का फिगर दिख रहा है, जैसे आपका मोबाइल स्क्रीन आप सामने लाते हैं उसमें तो जो पहले नहीं था वो वहां पे उसे सडनली सामने आ जाता है. दिस इज, कैन आई रिक्वेस्ट एवरीबॉडी एल्स टू म्यूट द, थैंक यू सो मच. दिस इज ऑगमेंटेड रियलिटी. वर्चुअल रियलिटी आप भी आपने देखा होगा, यू कैन वेयर दोस ग्लासेस एंड यू गेट द इमेज of something which doesn't exist. It, they say on the center, jo aapko ek bottom center pe aapko jo dikh raha hai moving image, jaise aap jaise us tunnel mein ja rahe hain aisa aapko feel ho raha hai, that is virtual reality. Jo aap ye top left pe dekh rahe hain, that is mixed reality. Matlab this is a combination. Now ये टेबल पे ये कोई आर्किटेक्ट हैं जो अपना किसी क्लाइंट को समझा रही हैं कि आपका घर कैसे दिखने वाला है. नाउ देयर इज नथिंग ऑन द टेबल, इट इज जस्ट गेटिंग क्रिएटेड एंड द क्लाइंट इज एबल टू विजुअलाइज हाउ हिज हाउस इज गोइंग टू लुक लाइक इन रियल टाइम. जिस टेबल के चारों ओर सब लोग खड़े हुए हैं, डिस्कशन चालू है. इस टाइप की टेक्नोलॉजीज और इस टाइप का क्रिएशन वर्क इंडिया में हो रहा है. तो यू शुड दीज आर सम ऑफ द इमर्जिंग टेक्नोलॉजीज विच आर देयर इमर्जिंग. दीज आर ऑल रियलिटी टुडे, दीज आर नॉट फ्यूचरिस्टिक, दीज आर ऑल टुडे जो आज की तारीख में हो रहा है. गेम बेस्ड लर्निंग इज अनदर एरिया वेयर लर्निंग इज हैपनिंग थ्रू वेराइटी ऑफ गेमिंग टेक्नोलॉजीज. डिजिटल पब्लिकेशंस आर देयर, 3D printing is there, you know, where manufacturing can be done, where physical objects can be created just the way you print a 2D paper instead of printing something on a 2D paper. Actual material is fed into a printer and let's say an Eiffel Tower can be created like you see on the top right hand side on in front of the printing machine, your right hand side pe it's what it is called a printer, 3D printer, and this physical object of three Eiffel Tower has got created on a table. This is not an image, this is a real object. So these are the kind of technologies which are today emerging, and you should be look at doing courses in these technologies also. So now going forward, these were some of the projections which were made before COVID for these sectors. These projections were made, I repeat, before COVID for these sectors. And when I talked about particularly gaming, digital media, these are going to increase far higher. I talked about animation and VFX, which are today getting consumed digitally. So the growth, if that could be much higher as well. So these are some of the sectors which within the media and entertainment industry, which are going to increase, could be higher than what was projected even before the COVID scenario emerged. So just on the some of the areas which got leveraged because of the COVID scenario, lockdown scenarios, this helped build new terminologies. We were sitting at home watching movies. We were sitting at home learning new things. We were sitting at home learning new courses. We were doing various kinds of we were playing games. So because of this, a lot of trends have emerged for these sectors in during the lockdown period also. And this trend is likely to continue after the lockdown also. I've already talked about this, where there was a spike across all the OTT platforms like Netflix, Hotstar, Amazon Prime, Voot, Sony Live, Jio. All these, there was a lot of consumption was getting consumed. So these are some of the kind of other names who are there in the OTT field. Alt Balaji is there. Eros Now, yes, I forgot. Eros Now, Jio Cinema, and many others. Video chats actually turned social distancing into distant socializing.
Yes.
So we are today talking much more. We are talking on videos. We are talking. So those technologies have also received a boost during this time. I've talked about popularity of video-led social platforms like Facebook and Instagram, which has improved during lockdowns. आप लोग TikTok जरूर देखते होंगे, मैं भी देखता हूँ. These are top gainers in terms of downloads. Amount of work which is happening and amount of small films which are being created for TikTok is unbelievable, simply unbelievable. And you can learn how to create the films. You can learn what are the techniques involved in doing such things. The fitness industry also got a boost because people were locked down. They were doing various streaming services and doing yoga, doing exercises, fitness at home. There were a lot of games which got produced during this period, and a lot of people were playing games during this period. So now my last one or two slides are on the career opportunities. By now, you would have seen that एक जो हम मीडिया एंड एंटरटेनमेंट से चालू हुए थे बिगनिंग ऑफ द टॉक में और घुसते 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 हमने देखा उसके अंदर एक एनिमेशन विजुअल इफेक्ट्स होता है. फिर हमने देखा उस एनिमेशन विजुअल इफेक्ट्स भी किस टाइप के होते हैं, वो किस किस फील्ड्स में यूज हो सकते हैं और हो रहे हैं, कैसे कैसे टेक्नोलॉजीज हैं. तो जैसे जैसे आप घुसते जाओगे एक एक फील्ड में, आप रियलाइज करते जाओगे कि उस फील्ड में अलग अलग अपॉर्चुनिटीज और अलग अलग areas and disciplines emerge hote chale jate hain. It's a very wide, it's a very deep field, the media and entertainment industry, and you can get, you can choose any of these and many more. This is also not the entire lot. There are hundreds more of these which you, for you to choose only among from the four that I talked about. There are other areas also. I talked about animation, I talked about visual effects, I talked about digital media, I talked about gaming, yeah, and I talked about multimedia and interactive design. So these are only five that I talked about. And uske andar bhi aap dekh sakte ho, various kinds of courses are today there with various kinds of training providers. You can do courses ranging from 3 months to 3 years. Depend karta hai aapke kya objectives hain wo course karne ke liye. Animation mein kai type ke courses hote hain. You can become an animator, you can become a modeling artist, you can become a texturing artist, you can become a rigger, you can become an FX artist, lighting artist, layout artist, or you are, there are courses also where you can learn multiple skills together. You can learn all these skills, and there are courses, you should always choose more than one skill, you know, and best is to choose a longer term course which is encapsulating more than one thing, so that to, when you join a studio, you may be joining as a modeler, but tomorrow they may have an opening as a texturing artist, so that you are ready to become a texturing artist also. So try and choose courses which have multiple skills built into them, and also try and choose courses which teach you the principles of animation. जैसे आप गाड़ी सीखते हो तो आप सेंट्रो सीखना मत सीख, सेंट्रो चलाना नहीं सीखते हो, आप गाड़ी चलाना सीखते हो. Similar is the case with animation. आप animation करना सीखते हो, आप अपने उसकी creative skill सीखते हो, जिसमें आप एक particular technology या एक particular skill सीख पाते हो, using 3D Max या holding 3D Maya या any particular software which is used. So don't get fixated by any one particular software कि मेरे को Maya का course करना है या मुझे 3D Max का course करना है. नहीं, आपने देखना है कि आप उस वो चीज किस पर्पस के लिए यूज हो रही है और आप उसकी क्रिएटिविटी को कैसे जाहिर कर पाते हो. तो ट्राई एंड बिकम एन एनिमेटर एंड डोंट बिकम अ 3D Max पर्सन. 3D Max यू मे बी एनिमेशन मे बी टॉट टू यू यूजिंग 3D Max, बट इफ वंस यू हैव लर्नड एनिमेशन, वंस यू हैव लर्नड द आर्ट बिहाइंड इट, यू विल बी एबल टू अप्लाई इट इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ व्हिचएवर सॉफ्टवेयर इज कम्स टुमारो. Similarly, if you choose courses in visual effects, you can become a compositor, you can become a matte painter, you can become a match move artist, a roto artist, an FX artist, motion graphics artist, a stereo compositor. In digital media, there are skills courses like graphic designer, UI UX designer, web designer, interactive designer, 2D animator, visual design visualizer. In gaming, you can become a environment artist, level designer, concept designer, texturing artist. You can become a game tester. Gaming mein kai cheez hai. You can become a game developer. You can learn game art. You can learn game design. There are many different aspects. So of each one of these areas by itself. So aapke man mein ek question aa raha hoga. One of you, some of you may be thinking, arre baba, how will I know which one to choose, and will, how will I get confused? So I think it is important for you to reach out to companies who have a good counseling system who will be able in a position to explain you on a one-to-one basis what each one of these areas means. They will also understand your profile and then be able to fit together between you, your parents, and the counselor. You will be able to make the right choice for yourself. I think this is my last slide, but according to me, this is my most important slide. मैंने बहुत कोई बात करी है regarding technology, मैंने बहुत सारी बात करी है regarding different areas, मैंने बहुत सारी बात करी है regarding different skills. जैसे मैंने पिछली वाली स्लाइड पे आपको कुछ samples दिखाए किस टाइप के skills में आप जा सकते हैं. लेकिन आप किसी भी स्किल पे जाइए, इट इज आपने एक क्वेश्चन अपने आप से जरूर पूछना है. क्या आप 3 महीने के लिए अपनी लाइफ बना रहे हैं, 3 साल के लिए बना रहे हैं, या 30 साल के लिए बना रहे हैं? ये क्वेश्चन आपने जरूर पूछना चाहिए अपने आप से. यू मस्ट आस्क द क्वेश्चन टू योरसेल्फ, आर यू डूइंग दिस कोर्स फॉर द नेक्स्ट 3 मंथ्स बेनिफिट, नेक्स्ट 3 इयर्स बेनिफिट, और 30 इयर्स बेनिफिट? If you are doing it only for 3 months, you can do anything. It does not matter. But if you are trying it to do build a career or get, if your objective is to get a job, you have to understand that what it takes to get a job. If you know just the technical skills, the first one in yellow here, then you know only 1 out of the 6 things which are required. People will not hire you if you know only the technical skills, but you do not know you're not good at anything else. The second most important thing is becoming industry ready. What do you mean by becoming industry ready? Matlab aap agar main kisi ko recruit karna cha raha hu, mera maan lijiye studio hai aur main recruit karna cha raha hu, suppose I have a studio and I'm trying to recruit somebody, my objective will be that I want somebody who can work from day one so that I don't have to train him again. That is very important. If I have to train him again or put something, train him more than what he already knows, then that person is not industry ready. So you should look at courses which make you industry ready. You should be employable on day one. You should look at creativity, because if your course is making you creative, then it does not matter which technical skill you have learned. It does not matter whether you are an animator or a visual effects artist. If you have developed your creativity, aaj 5 saal baad, 10 saal baad, 30 saal baad, wo creativity aap mein se kahin nahi jayegi. Wo creativity aapke andar hamesha hamesha ke liye rahegi. बट वो क्रिएटिविटी आपके कोर्स के थ्रू ही मिलेगी, वो इसी दौरान पे मिलेगी, लेकिन वो आपको लॉन्ग टर्म के लिए फायदा देगी. इट विल लास्ट यू फॉर अ वेरी वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम. इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट दैट यू लर्न टीम वर्क. ये सिंगल आदमी का स्पोर्ट नहीं है. इट इज नॉट अ स्पोर्ट, इट इज नॉट समथिंग वेयर यू वर्क अलोन, विच आई विल ऑल्सो कम, यू कैन ऑल्सो वर्क अलोन, बट most companies you have to work in a team where you are doing only one aspect of the job, every other aspect is done by somebody else. So how good are your teamwork skills? Aap logon ke sath kaisa kaam kar sakte hain? Can you work with other people? This also has to be taught to you. Most important in this industry is working under deadlines. Everything has a deadline. If something has to be delivered by on 31st of May, it has to be delivered on 31st of May. How to do that? And what are the pressures which you have to be get used to working under those pressures? These are methodologies which good companies use in their teaching approach, in the pedagogy, in the teaching approach, to be able to teach you such things. Resilience. Resilience kya hota hai? Resilience hota hai ki आप मान लीजिए फेल कर गए, आपने जॉब के लिए अप्लाई कर दिया, आपको रिजेक्ट हो गया, या हो सकता है आपने बहुत अच्छा वर्क किया, अकॉर्डिंग टू यू यू प्रोड्यूस द बेस्ट क्वालिटी वर्क दैट वाज पॉसिबल, बट द प्रोड्यूसर रिजेक्टेड इट ऑन द फर्स्ट मीटिंग. नाउ यू फील डिसअपॉइंटेड, you feel down. But how do you come back quickly? Now, these are personality traits which can be taught to you, which must be taught to you. How to develop your personality, how to make you more confident, how good are you in communication? Kya aap communicate kar pate hain apni baat? Ye sari skills milke hi aapko job milta hai. Sirf technical skills se aapko job nahi milta hai. To aapne wo course choose karna hai jo aapko ye sari cheez de paaye. Or you should question your counselors as to how you will be able to develop these skills if you were to do that course. See, mere se shuru mein Pooja ne pucha tha ki question of online and offline. Mere hisab se, you know, while technical skills to online padhai ja sakti hain kuch had tak, kafi had tak. Agar right technology ho, internet speed achhi ho, right teachers ho aur bachon ka motivation acha ho to padhai ja sakti hai. Technical skills at least 80-90% tak padhai ja sakti hai, but baki sab cheez ko padhana bada mushkil hai online world. For that, a certain amount of what jisko hum log blended learning kehte hain, physical learning is important. You have to be able to work with other people and work in skills. Halanki kai companies aisi hain jisme technological tools hain aaj ki tarikh mein which are helping teach these skills, but you should be aware of that. This is the most important slide. Agar aapne kuch bhi aur nahi seekha in mere 50 slide mein se, agar aapne sirf ek slide seekhi to sirf ye slide seekhiyega. That is my request to you. Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure talking to you. Except the last point that I want to make to you is that whenever you are going to do a course and you will go out in the world, ek cheez aap hamesha yaad rakhiyega, aapke jaise 10,000 log aur hain jo wahi cheez seekh ke aaye hain, to aap apne aap ko kaise distinguish kar pate hain, unse alag kaise dikha pate hain, aur how are you able to stand out from the crowd is an important aspect, and uska bahut important role padta hai on these kind of skills which are there. Sorry, Pooja, for overshooting my time a little bit, but I thought this was important.
No, sir, it was really, really, really knowledgeable, and I'm sure everybody must have learned, and especially your last slide. It's like a lesson for lifetime.
True.
Yes. So before you leave, may I have a personal note for students looking for education in the field of animation, VFX, gaming, and of course, digital media?
मैं सिर्फ दो चीज़ कहना चाहूँगा कि कोई भी आप फील्ड चूज़ करें, चाहे एनिमेशन चूज़ करें, विजुअल इफेक्ट्स चूज़ करें या कोई भी और चूज़ करें जो आप, डू इट विद पैशन. अगर आप अपने वो चीज़ कर रहे हैं जिससे आप पैशनेट हैं, जिस बारे में आपको अच्छा लगता है करना, आप उसी चीज़ में सक्सेसफुल हो पाते हैं इन द लॉन्ग रन. सिर्फ वो उस चीज़ में मत जाइए क्योंकि मेरा दोस्त जा रहा है, या उस चीज में मत जाइए क्योंकि मेरा ब्रदर भी उस फील्ड में था या मेरे फादर भी उस फील्ड में थे. वो चीज, मेरा हमेशा ये सजेशन रहता है, आई हैव इंटरेक्टेड विद मोर देन लैक्स एंड लैक्स ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स बाय नाउ इन माय लॉन्ग कैरियर, बट मैं सबको एक चीज कहता हूँ, मैंने निचोड़ देख लिया है कि only people who are passionate about what they do will be successful, and this is particularly important in this area. So be passionate about what you do and do what you are passionate about.
Yes, exactly. That's another mantra given by Anuj sir today. I hope everybody have clicked their photos with Anuj sir and selfies, and they are going to upload it on social media, tagging MESC and Vidya. One last thing, I would like to know about the programs you can offer and how admissions are going on even during the COVID situation.
See, what I will request, Pooja, is that I will request my team to take over at this stage, and who can then explain or answer some of the questions with the people have on sure. specifics of this. I'm sure they will. I have a very able team from the company who are today with me, and they will take it forward from here.
Sure, sir. Thank you so much.
So my last word to the students is, don't go away. I think there are good people who are there to answer your questions and answer